where these grist mills were built became the center of a community quite often, and which then developed into, well, we need a store here too, because these people want more than just have their grain taken care of.
Cox's Mills was named from a family of Coxes. They had a mill, and of course one of them owned the post office.
The first post office in Ritchie County was in Pennsboro in 1823. One post office was Racket. That's out on the eastern end of the Turnpike, close to the Gilmer County line. And the story there is that they used to have boxing matches there. And the noise from the crowd made such a racket that people from several miles around could hear that the boxing match was going on. And so they'd go to see the fight. And so it got called Racket.
My grandfather, Nutter, had a store, and he would get barrels of lamp oil. You know it as kerosene. And they'd unload them at the mouth of Standing Stone over there onto a horse and wagon. And it was a day's run for him to come with the horses to meet the boat.
Before the turnpike, they used bridle paths, and then they developed wagon roads.
The first stores that were put into Troy, they got their supplies from the trains at Weston. And they took four horses, with a heavy road wagon and go to Weston and load it and come back. And it was a 2-day trip. And sometimes they would load so heavy, two wagons would get together, which was four teams of horses. And when they come to the Camden Hill, it was very steep in places. They would help each other pull the loaded wagon to the top of the hill. Then they would go back with the four teams to the foot of the hill. Wes and Cecil Heckert had a store in Troy. It was not very wide, but it was probably 60 feet long. Right inside the door, there were benches for the loafers, the loafering bench. In the center of the floor was a trap door, and all you had to do to open that trap door was go over and step on the lever, and the lid would open, and you could spit your tobacco juice down that hole in the floor. Honest to goodness, there were many elderly people that spent their time just loafing there with Wes and Cecil Heckert. But this tobacco juice spitting was very, very popular. I think tobacco took the place of drinking for those older fellows at that time.
Yeah, there used to be a store down here at Cisco. You'd go down there and get what they had to sell. Charlie Marshall owned a store. I had a riding horse, and I rode the horse down there at the store. Maybe I had a couple dozen eggs on one arm. I'd go down there, and he'd come out and get the eggs, and then he'd get what Mama wrote down, get back on my horse and go home.